but where once we felt the colors we belong. To Algonquin, Algonquin, Algonquin.
July 16, 1917. The body of a man is discovered in the waters of Canoe Lake, Algonquin Park. Reports indicate there is fishing line wrapped 16 or 17 times around one ankle, some evidence of bleeding from one ear, and a 4-inch bruise across the left temple. The coroner concludes, accidental death from drowning.
Without ever bothering to look at the body.
The first report of the man's disappearance had been 7 days earlier, July 9th, his overturned canoe having been found floating on the lake. The day after the canoe was found...
For some reason, no one's ever rightly explained to me.
The canoe disappeared again. 15 years later, a painter from the Group of Seven, a Mr. Lauren Harris, came to visit a family in the park.
It was August. I had accepted an invitation to a day of fishing, and it was approaching dusk as we began canoeing home.
A mist rising in the water.
When suddenly the youngest daughter shouted,
"Look! Father must be coming to meet us!"
I turned towards the moon to see where the daughter was pointing, and there, carrying in a canoe and paddling towards us was a man, now a little less than 100 yards away. A loon cried from the other side of the lake, and the little girl jumped.
I was getting frightened, but I didn't know why.
But then the man in the canoe lifted his arm, waved at us.
And suddenly, I felt better.
And just as he was close enough for us to see his face, a cloud covered over the moon. And when the moon reappeared, he was gone.
The man, the canoe, everything.
He was simply no longer there.
The child kept insisting later that the man was wearing a yellow shirt.
Father never wears yellow, dear.
The man they saw that night was the same man who drowned in that lake 15 years earlier. Painter and outdoorsman Tom Thompson.
Ranger Robinson told them they'd been seeing things.
Mr. Harris, being a more spiritual man than some.
It is a popular belief that I have no intention of disputing that those who depart before their time continue to haunt the lands they loved. I am certain that what we saw that night was the spirit, Tom Thompson.
For years after, folks around the park used to argue about what color shirt Thompson was wearing the day he drowned.
I like to think it was yellow.
It was yellow.
After Thompson's death in 1917, the park wardens and guides searched every inch of Canoe Lake for Tom's hand-painted canoe and paddle.
They were never found.
I've never seen a frozen waterfall until I saw one at Algonquin Park. It's an unnerving sight. There it is, this immense cacophony of ice. When it glistens in the winter sun, a little surface water scurries down to these tiny rivers, or more precisely into the illusion of rivers, because the real power is hidden somewhere deep inside. Dig a hole and put your hand in to feel that power, and the frost will bite it off. That waterfall, on a windless night, makes no sound at all, frozen so solid, bullets bounce off. But in the spring it has the power to inspire and destroy. In the trees not far away, I turned around to face the sound, and she was standing there, the girl with thunder in her hair. She held out her hand, and with a voice so reed, said, come and let me show you things no man has ever seen. But I said, no, I shall not go. But then to my surprise, I could see the lightning in her eyes.
Come away with me, and together we will be.
Two stormy west wind lovers in a tumble to the sea. Come and touch my dress, feel the rain in my caress. I was tempted, yes, but did I dare go with the girl with thunder in her hair? As an ordinary man, there are rules I mustn't break, roads I mustn't travel, and risks I daren't take. And yet when she appeared to me, I couldn't help but care for the girl with thunder in her hair.
Come away with me, and together we will be.
Like leaves upon a river in a tumble to the sea.
Come and touch my skin like a lover's mandolin.
Take the river in beneath the changing skies, said the girl with the lightning in her eyes. But I dared not go with so much I didn't know. So I turned back towards the city, and the wind began to blow. And her eyes flashed gold, and her hair flew uncontrolled, till I couldn't bear not being there with the girl with thunder in her hair.
I know what they're saying. The children call me witch. Their parents, of course, would just wild Winnie. Crazy old spinster who lost her last chance at a man in the water of the Canoe Lake. But to the writers, the journalists, the busybodies, is it true you were engaged to him, Miss Thompson? Is it true that he committed suicide rather than marry you? Tell us, Miss Trainer, who really killed Tom Thompson? I'm 77 this year. 40 years ago, disappeared never to be found alive again. They say it changed after he died. That I kept too many things buried inside myself, and what they really want to know is, they so desperately want to know what I know. Well, this I will tell you. We were fishing when we first met, and I was always damn better at fishing than he ever was.
Any luck, Winnie?
No need for luck, Martin. Fishing is an art.
Haven't caught anything yet.
Not a nibble.
Bessie invited Harry McLeod over for supper tonight.
Your sister and Harry McLeod?
I was wondering if you wanted to come over for dinner.
I'm making dinner for my folks tonight.
Yeah. Some other time then.
Who's that?
I don't know. But whoever it is can't paddle a canoe. Look at him. He can't even keep it on the water.
He's not that bad.
Must be from the city. Look at him. He's terrible. Must be from Toronto.
He's coming ashore here. Now keep your voice down.
Hello.
Hello, Fred. No, for a less demanding art, I'm afraid.
You see, Martin, fishing is an art.
I fish. I'd enjoy chasing a few trout if I knew how to cast.
If you stay a while, I could take you out and show you. Ours is the first white cabin past the point.
Ours is a big one, two down.
You're staying at the Moat Lodge.
I will be. I'm just up from the city today. Could have gone with the wagon they sent to the station, but I wanted to see all this from the water first. Silly, I suppose, because I have no idea at the moment where the Moat Lodge is.
You're the painter, I expect. You're not going to cut off your ear, I hope.
What?
Only if it'll make effective bait.
What are you two on about?
My father and I are going out at around 5 tomorrow if you care to angle with us.
point.
I was thinking about going fishing myself, actually.
Get lost, ask for the trainer.
Till tomorrow morning, then, Miss Trainer.
Martin Bletcher! You don't even know his name.
Of course I do. His name's Tom Thompson. Care to walk me home, maybe?
My name's Shannon Fraser. For 17 years I ran the Mowat Lodge. 2 miles from the train depot and even closer to the Canoe Lake Burying Ground. Location is everything. 13 years after Thompson died, the Mowat burnt to the ground and I left this park forever. But, as they say, the legend of Shannon Fraser stayed on. It was me reported seeing him canoe off that last morning. Last man to see him alive. But it was also me that got accused, by my own wife no less, of having murdered him myself. Tried to sell his boots after his death, I did, if you believe him that says it. Though truth be told, check out the painting he done to me. You don't think he looked at me with as much red in his eyes as I had looking at him. Anyway, this is the Mowat Lodge. Weren't such a bad place in those days. Food was edible, no mosquitoes in the whiskey. And this is where the great Tom Thompson used to stay until the snow went. Snow never went soon enough for me.
Here you go, Doctor. Guitar good, Algonquin Park air.
Thank you, Mrs. Fraser.
And I brought a blanket against the chill.
Bit of hooch, perhaps, Doctor? Parts of a man no blanket can warm.
It's rest the doctor needs, Shannon. And fresh air.
Please, I don't mean to be a nuisance. And if this gentleman is going to find me a bother, I can just as easily...
Doctor, please. I'd rather hope you had
Annie?
Tried.
I don't see the doctor's breakfast tray.
Stay wherever you are, Doctor. Meet a fellow guest. Dr. McCallum, Tom Thompson.
Doctor.
It's Jim.
Just seen on yesterday's train. Here for the cure.
If I'm going to disturb you, I can...
Good of you to go, Thompson.
It's just that the light here...
Please. For the next few months, I'm to be considered part of the flora and fauna.
Thank you.
You're a painter, Tom?
No.
I've met a few painters, though not many modest ones. In fact, it was Lauren Harris who recommended this lodge. Said there's something about the colors, which is true, I suppose, if you like green. You know Lauren?
I know he's a fine painter.
Have you some I can see? Good, aren't they?
Well, they're just sketches.
I think they're very good.
Hot mush.
Shannon.
No offense, Thompson, but aren't these more like a gargle or a gob of porridge than an honest painting?
No offense. Take it, I'm sure. You've studied, Tom?
A lesson or two.
You actually saw these colors in the park?
Yes, there. Last Thursday, 7 a.m.
I used to wish I could do this. Pictures. Where my mother worked, I used to look at the drawings in the books they had, wondering what their stories were, wanting to go to those places and maybe do my own pictures of the things I'd see.
And did you?
No.
You should now.
No.
Please.
I couldn't.
It's, Lauren Harris, Doctor.
Please, Tom, I didn't mean...
Thank you.
You know, Miss Fraser, I'm no expert, but I could teach you what little I know about all this.
She's not interested, Thompson.
At least help you get started.
It's a generous offer.
It was a long time ago. It don't matter now.
It matters more now.
Enough to be done around here without taking time for, foolishness.
Well, the offer's made.
Annie, we best be getting to our chores.
You don't mind if I keep her for a few more moments, do you, Fraser? I'll need someone to take away my tray.
It's my chores, then.
Now, Annie, you mustn't bother Tom anymore. genius at work. Vanguard of the new hot mush school of Canadian art. As for you, Tom, you've a way to go yet to convince me of these colors. Though, perhaps if you painted it warmer, it would be warmer. Or, better yet, take pity on an old man and paint me in the south of France on a sun-swept beach without a spot on my lung.
I'll do that, Doctor.
Lovely. It feels warmer already.
Treehouse, my father built.
least I can do in return for the invitation.
Oh, say no trouble. Simple, humble father.
I'm sure it'll seem like a feast, Mother. Is Thompson being more used to pancakes and bacon, I think, than what a few fish he can catch?
I'm catching more.
Why are we coming out here? It's going to rain, for God's sake.
Phew, your language.
What's the matter with my goddamn language? How about a brandy, Tom?
Yes, thank you.
I'll join you.
Good lad. Excuse me, Apple.
Winifred. Mom! Please don't fuss, Mother. You'll give Mr. Thompson entirely the wrong idea about us.
She hardly fusses at all, Mr. Thompson. She's really just as bohemian as the rest of us.
I most certainly am not.
Could you clear a patch over there? Over there. We never put part of the garden over there.
For the carrots.
Carrots have gone over there for 10 years. What are you going to put over there?
Thought peas.
The peas go over there, Winnie Trainer. What in the world has gotten into you?
Three brandies.
What do you think she's going to put the peas over there?
Damn good place for them. Just don't plant squash. Disgusting vegetable.
What's your favorite vegetable, Mr. Thompson? Tom?
Pardon?
Are you feeling quite well?
Yes, fine.
Mrs. Trainer? Mr. Trainer?
Oh, hello, Martin.
Bleacher? Bletcher. Winnie? Thompson? Working on the garden, I see?
What do you think, Martin? Peas over there or over there?
Don't the peas always go over there?
Exactly. Thank you, Martin.
Good drainage over there. Good drainage is always good for peas, though.
So peas over there, I think.
So, Tom. Much money in painting?
Gee, what kind of question is that?
A damn straightforward one.
No, not much.
Wouldn't have thought so. Expect you'd have to be dead first.
You trainer!
Well, isn't that the way of the world?
Mr. Thompson isn't concerned about the money, Father. He's interested in the art.
I'd love to make money at it, some people do.
So how do you make a living?
He draws pictures for the Eaton's catalog.
The Eaton's catalog? No, the Eaton's catalog.
During the winter, I work for a commercial art firm in Toronto.
But we love the Eaton's catalog. We must be very talented.
I use the Eaton's catalog. You know where. So, do you make enough in the winter to support yourself in the park all summer?
Oh, do stop badgering Mr. Thompson about money, Hugh. Surely there are more pleasant things we can talk about. Let's see. Are you married, Mr. Thompson? You're sure you're all right?
No, I'm not married. Although, I did propose once. In Seattle, I was 27, she was 15, the daughter of a minister. And she laughed at me. She asked me, Alice was her name, she said, would I paint her in the nude? And I said, of course I won't, what would your father say? And she said,
why should you care what my father thinks?
But I did care. And besides, I was a letterman, not an artist. She wanted to write novels.
Scandalous ones, with lots of plot.
I left Seattle the next day. Alice Lambert. And you know what she does now? She writes novels. Look at that gray.
Pardon?
The sky.
Yes, the sky. Very nice.
Keeps changing.
There's something very odd about that lady.
He's probably wondering what the hell we're doing out here when it's going to start raining any second. I'm uncomfortable enough all week at the mill as it is. I'm going inside, Marie.
Yes, perhaps we should. You will join us for dinner, Martin.
Well, as a matter of fact, yes. Thank you, Mrs. Fanning.
Just give me a minute to set another place. I should have some seed markers.
I got some seed markers back at the cabin. I could be back in.
Thank you, Martin. I don't believe I've ever met someone like you.
I'm sorry, I shouldn't have talked about those things.
Well, I find them very interesting.
So still? Calm before the storm? We'd make a terrible married couple.
Every year we set up the garden the same way. It's always been just vegetables. Maybe this year some flowers.
Goodbye, Tom.
Bye.
I should go.
But you haven't had dinner yet.
I have to try and get that gray.
Well, tonight's no night to be out on the water. You know, careful enough. You know not to be careful, I hope.
Yes. I got the sea markers. Good night.
Good night, Mr. Thompson. Dinner's on, Martin.
Yes. Thank you, Mrs. Trainer.
I'll be right there. Is that him? He has to try and get that gray. On a night like this? Are you certain about this man, Hugh, or Gwenny? He seems so passionate. I would have thought passion was a good quality in a man, only if it's directed towards us here. Well, I can't say I'm unhappy with this one.
Yes, Mother, but he'll be back.
Don't the dangerous ones always come back? Have you come inside, Gwenny? Filmed a poor like Judgment Day.
I used to come across Thompson the odd time in the park. Part of my job being to look for poachers. Poachers I didn't already know, that is. Afternoon, Larry.
Robinson!
Out for a stroll, are ya?
That's it. Out for a stroll. Poaching's illegal.
I know that.
But if I see anyone poaching, I'm sure that one of your rangers know.
Appreciate it, Larry.
Though, come to think of it, there's this new guy. Tall. Suspicious looking.
Suspicious.
Shifty. Takes these bits of board and dabs specks of paint on them. Don't know what he's doing, but it's worth watching anyways.
Well, is he an artist?
A what?
An artist.
What the hell type of thing's that?
So I try my best to explain to him what an artist is.
Well, I don't know none about that.
But he's worth watching anyways.
It's no account like that that leaves no rap for the rest of us.
They call it a pine tree. Millions of those jack pines in this park, and they all look like that one.
We've had artists in the park before. Tom never claimed to be the first, but few so much as made the place home. Not that he was any expert that first year.
Look at that brown.
I helped out when I could.
In the bush.
Fern. Osmond the fern turns that shade after the first frost. And more often than not, he'd try to give me what he called his boards. The longer he stayed, the less folks knew what to make of him. There was this one time, he near scared Winnie's mother half to death, came barging into her kitchen.
I need a swamp. Birdie, swampy, with those things that stick up. And grays, everywhere, different grays.
She thought for a minute and suggested he try the little lake.
Marsh Hare, behind the old timber camp.
Without so much as a goodbye.
Without so much as a goodbye. You ask me, Mark Robinson, that man is demented.
Popular opinion ran pretty much with Winnie's mother.
Pixelated.
Moonstruck, they said.
Crazy as a North Bay coot.
Either that or a very smart poacher.
I don't think folks around here ever really understood Thompson. Seems to me there was only one place a person got to know the real Thompson, because if he was never very happy with his painting, he sure was proud of one thing.
Crown Kinglet.
Could be. For the grosbeak myself.
Cretan? Pointed sparrow.
Ah! Larry Dixon set an illegal trap lines. Good thing for him it's my day off.
Catbird? Warbler.
Plenty of birds. No fish.
Sure there's a lot of water out here. Shouldn't have had that second cup of coffee.
Christmas, Tom. You're not going to do that out here? Don't you know standing up in the canoe is just about the stupidest thing you can do? It is a verifiable fact that the majority of drowned fishermen are found with their flies open.
Well, at least you're not comfortable. Paper frog.
Gonna paint today?
Too green. Green's boring as hell. Early spring and fall is the time to paint.
Meaning you're too lazy. Where'd you get the lures?
My bugs, I painted them myself. You like them?
Never was much for the hot mush school of fishing lures. Hey, I think I just made a joke.
Fishing's the joke, Robinson.
No, I did. Hot mush school of fish lures.
I think you've been out in the sun too long.
No sense of humor.
Oh, we'll catch some fish.
As soon as I get my line in.
Fish are the real critics. They take one look at my lure, see all there is to see, then calmly swim away.
Seen the Baron lately?
I had him over for dinner last week.
No, the Baron.
He said to say hello.
And if anyone ever does catch the Baron, it sure won't be some city boy.
Had him on the line, had him a yard from the net.
No kidding.
Could have counted his fin stripes.
So?
Damn thing winked at me, tossed his head and disappeared.
Fish don't wink. You've got no eyelids. You know that if you ever caught one.
He winked in recognition of me as a fellow artist.
Artist my ass, but distrust. The Baron's a ranger. Superior survival skills.
Somewhere in the murkiness of this water lies the Baron, and I want the Baron. Shit.
Tom, you got something. Christmas is a big one.
Is it the Baron?
I can't see. Bring it closer. I'll be jiggered. It could be.
I got him.
A little more.
Ah, no.
Stop.
Damn.
You had him!
I had him.
Couldn't tell if it was the Baron.
Damn.
No sense getting mad. Didn't know if it was even him.
I know. Why do you think I'm mad?
This here behind me is my shack. You probably recognize it. Of course, you probably recognize me for that matter. The hat, the axe, Larry Dixon, splitting wood, right? I knew you'd recognize me eventually. Hell, if I haven't been kept in all them private collection all these years, I'd be as famous as one of them Jack Pines you kept painting. Folks say, artsy folks that is, that Tom wasn't all that good at painting people. Have no opinion on that. Just know I like to be painted. Built this shack myself. Wasn't much. Wasn't ever meant to be. Any Fraser come by one night. Not for what you think. Though some did. What did she say? Had potential. Hell, if it was more drafts and conscription and plant quarter mile up the path. And then, this one summer, Thompson brought this Lismer fella. And I guess when Lismer was tired of trapping through the woods fighting squitters, he sat down and painted a picture of my shack. He actually took the time and painted a picture of my shack. Hell, I didn't know whether to laugh or cry. And then a few months later, he sold the damn thing for $400. $400. For a picture of Larry Dixon's shack. Sorry, the guide's home. Some jackass city slicker. Hell, I didn't know whether to laugh or cry. Laughing gave me away from poaching. Well, I guess it goes to show you, you never know what's got potential. Larry Dixon splitting wood. $400, please.
Colleen is ever a moon painted gold.
You used to say those things and mean them.
I was an idiot boy once, to be sure.
I liked that idiot boy. Happy birthday, Shannon.
Annie. Thank you.
They're wind chimes. Every time you hear them, you can think of me.
And paint it.
Yes.
Thompson's a good teacher.
Happy birthday.
Here they are.
Returns of the day, Shannon. These must be the famous wind chimes.
You heard that, Mrs. T, that my Annie's taking art lessons.
I did, yes.
Where is Thompson so I can thank him myself? I brought you some punch, Winnie.
Annie Fraser, fresh punch.
Mrs. Trent?
How gallant it is, sir. I do believe you're feeling better, Doctor.
Please, it's Jim. And yes, there may be some rough magic in this park air after all. The curse of good health may force me to leave you all sooner than I had begun to hope.
So you and Tom will both be returning to Toronto?
I didn't know about Tom.
Yes, enough time wasted here.
On your painting?
I'm a commercial artist, not a painter. Time to get back to that.
They need you for those Eaton catalogs, don't they?
I need the job.
Well, isn't this a surprise? But then, what's a birthday for if not for pleasant surprises?
Shannon.
Still,
No doubt he's looking forward to going back down to the city again, being with his high-class friends. I expect Martin's looking forward to it at any rate.
Shannon, please.
Am I not only saying what's true?
Not that we won't miss you, of course, Tom.
The rent on the room, anyway.
Mrs. Traynor, have you seen the painting Tom did of the mullet?
No, I don't think I have.
I've convinced Mrs. Fraser to hang it in the parlor. Perhaps you'd let me show you.
Yes.
And Tom, if you accompany us, there's something we might discuss.
Well, of course.
That's right, Tommy. Off you go. Leave Martin and I to have some real fun on our own. How about you and I have a little arm wrestle? See if you've improved any.
No.
You can fight for your beloved Germans, and I'll be our Canadian boys in France.
I'm an American.
Martin and his German ancestry don't think we have any chance.
Thousands of Canadians killed already. Loss of good men.
Brave men, dying for a just cause.
Though I know, Thompson, half you are here.
Tom tried to enlist. Give me a tongue.
What was it? Flat feet?
What about you, Fletcher? Are you brave enough to fight?
As an American, I have no need. It's in our conflict.
Not yet.
Not ever. Us Americans know not to get involved into something that isn't ours.
But are they smart enough to fly a flag properly? You hang that Stars and Stripes inside your cabin again, you remember to fly the Union Jack over top.
For what? Some coward comes in the middle of the night and tears it down again?
I wouldn't be surprised.
Now, boys! Not that I wouldn't relish a good fisticuffs, but if anyone's going to enjoy a good knockdown on my birthday, it's me. Now, as undisputed champion of Algonquin Park, I am duty-bound to put my title on the line as often as possible. Come on, Martin, roll up your sleeves.
I said no.
Besides, Shannon, Martin being a policeman, you could probably break your arm if you wanted to.
I'm an investigator, not a policeman.
Sure, Martin, we know that. Private investigator like Sherlock Holmes.
No.
Peeping through transoms at husbands, sneaking a little on the side.
What I do is good, honest work. Though I see enough men who don't.
Meaning who?
Meaning men rather live off of a woman than live off of their own. Gigolos, they're called. And worse, itinerant actors. Misunderstood artists.
Go get him, Martin!
I'm sure Martin didn't mean that the way it sounded.
You don't think so, Mrs. T?
Besides, this isn't the time for this.
And he's right. This is a party. Let's arm wrestle. What about you, Thompson? Never challenge a champ.
Not now, Shannon.
Sure, that's better. Off you go, Tommy, out of harm's way. You might sprain a wrist and poor Tommy if he couldn't lift that great big heavy paintbrush and dab those little bitty specks of paint all day.
Shannon!
I'll wrestle you.
All right, now we'll see something, eh, Martin? Good to know there's at least some of us here that don't back down from a fight.
You don't have to do this, Tom.
Now, Annie, let's give the city boy a chance to prove his mettle before we send him back home to his mama. Ready? And go!
Come on, Tom!
You
got it,
Tom!
You got it, Tom!
Come on, Tom!
Come on, Tom! You got it!
Come on, Tom! Go!
Yeah! Winner and still undisputed champion! Nice try, Tom!
Next time I'll use my good hand.
What?
I mean, next time I'll wrestle you using my strong hand.
Don't use any hand you like. Come on, again.
All right, what'll it be, my friend? Something in a jig, maybe?
Wildflowers.
Wow.
change.
You're acting like a damn fool. And as for you, Thompson, I'll thank you in future to keep your hands off of my wife.
I think we should go, Tom.
No! Now, before he fights me with his good hand, he's not going to make an ass out of me that easy.
Let's go, Winnie.
Thompson!
Tom, look out, sir!
This is my good hand, Fraser.
Winifred?
Happy birthday, Shannon.
Society of Artists' annual exhibit of new work. Most of the boys exhibit a piece or two every year. Harris, Lismer, Jackson.
How am I a ticket holder?
I've written to Harris about you. Sent him a couple of your pieces.
To Lauren Harris?
He had one hung at the OSA.
No.
Yes.
Which one?
Northern Lake.
Doctor, you had no right to send. And?
There were a few comments, of course.
Like what? What comments?
Well, that perhaps it was not completely under control.
What does that mean? Not completely under control? God damn critics would know a real goddamn painting if it came up and kicked them in the goddamn ass.
It's sold.
What?
To Her Majesty's Loyal Government of Ontario.
For how much?
$250. Took the liberty of bringing you the check. One last thing. I made a proposal to Alex Jackson last year. He accepted, and I hope you'll do the same. I'd like to guarantee your expenses for the period of 1 year if you'll devote that year to painting.
You want to pay me to paint?
You won't get rich from it. Enough to cover supplies, basic living expenses.
I won't waste your money.
This isn't charity. I'd consider it an investment. Frankly, if it had been me rather than the OSA selling that painting, we'd have made far more than 250. Besides, I rather like the idea of you letting things get even more out of control. A year starting today? Tom Thompson, painter.
Sky unit, flowing where the river flows.
colors of the river, the colors in my eyes. Northern river, can we ever know where these northern rivers go? Northern river, changing grays and blues. Northern river, take me with you.
There. What are you doing? Be careful with those. Who are you? Finally found one you like?
Ozma de Fern.
That's right.
After the first frost.
How did you know that?
That's what the hell it looks like. I'll take this one.
No, wait, you can't just take it.
Why? You let Dixon take one and give them to that ranger.
Yeah, sure, but...
Fine. Keep it. Gray in the sky is all wrong anyway.
Who are you?
Is that your canvas?
Canvas? No, I mean, one of them might make a canvas if I decide to do it later, but it's these first boards.
I said, is that your canvas pretending to be a tent?
Oh, my tent. Yes.
Better hope we don't get a wind. As you call that a campfire. Yeah. Them your boots?
Oh, not the right boots.
Some people think I'm a ghost. Do I feel like a ghost to you? Gray's all wrong, ain't it?
'19:15. I came across Thompson today at the edge of a river. Where's this river run? He said. I said, downstream. He didn't get it. It's a joke, I said. Bush humor. He just kept inching closer to the bank, and I said, be careful, rivers run quick this time of year. Doesn't look too dangerous, he said. And I said, it's nothing to do with how things look. I've seen guys who lived here all their lives, took one too many drinks, and ended up drowning in 6 inches of warm water. I didn't know it then. That's exactly what took Larry Dixon. I made a note, underlined it. Keep an eye on this Thompson. But if he wasn't careful, 1915 doesn't look too dangerous, he said.
good trout, Mr. Thompson.
You catch a good trout, Miss Trainer.
Maybe someday you'll catch one big enough to eat, too. Wild Mary.
What?
Your visitor the other day. Bit of a local legend. Lives in the bush exactly where no one seems to know for sure. Most people seem to think she died years ago. Do you believe in ghosts?
Not that carry kerosene lamps.
I don't believe in ghosts.
If you meet her again, be careful. She's been said to have done a lot of other things than stealing paintings.
Like what?
I'm too much of a lady to say. Tom, you started painting when?
Seriously? When I came to the park for the first time.
3 years ago. You were how old?
35.
I'm 35 this year. It's been so warm, it's nice to feel the wind. Tom, what's it feel like when you paint?
Good. I don't know. Scary sometimes. I don't know.
Good, but scary. When I was a kid, I used to explore the park by myself. I'd climb up into the trees as far from my cabin as I could, each day a little further. But when it felt scarier than good, I'd go home. Now I think about seeing the world. Africa. France.
I mean, you should go. You'll catch a chill.
I invited you over for dinner last Saturday.
I went north. I thought I was only going for a couple of days. I'm sorry.
Sorry.
The colors.
You don't have to explain.
I'm glad I didn't forget to.
Every year I'm more and more in time for everything. I hate that. You, on the other hand, are never on time for anything. You don't arrive at all if something better comes up.
Winnie, I'm sorry.
No, I like it that you're not run by what other people expect. That my mother thinks you're deranged. Sometimes I act a bit deranged myself just to drive her crazy. Maybe someday they'll be calling me Wild Winnie. Yeah. Have I ever told you about Angus McKenzie? First man ever asked me to marry him. If I'd married him, told me he'd take me anywhere in the world I wanted to go. He has 5 kids now. Have I ever told you about Howard Schneider?
No.
Best damn hockey player Huntsville ever produced. If I'd married him, I'd be living in the biggest house you ever saw in Montreal. But there's something else I thought I wanted. Not someone. A place, a feeling. It's like what always happens to me. I'll be doing something I do every day when all of a sudden, like a tree when the wind changes, I see things. Things I know aren't really there.
They are there.
No, but I feel like the wind's got inside me somehow and is churning around in there like a pile of fallen leaves, and I feel wet, exhilarated, and just for a second and then scared. And then it goes away. It always goes away.
It'll be dark soon. We should probably go.
Not yet.
Your parents won't be expecting you.
I came up by myself this weekend. There's a river runs off the lake not too far from here. Feel adventuresome?
What's down the river?
That's what makes it an adventure.
The water's not too fast?
For city folk, maybe.
Climb aboard.
After you.
I usually take the stern.
I know.
Don't you think it would be better?
Nope.
comfortable back there.
Keep the bow away from the pole.
Sorry.
Here's the breaker.
Exactly what it feels like, Winnie. That's exactly what it feels like to paint. The moon's bright tonight. Look at the light on the water. It looks like one color, but it's dozens of colors. Can you see them?
And what do you see when you look at me? How many colors?
We shouldn't canoe home in the dark.
No.
We'll stay and watch the light. The colors change on the water. The color of everything changes all the time, you know. What?
Everyone thinks you're crazy.
What about you?
I'm not crazy.
Winnie Trainor, you could be crazier than you think.
Comes the time when the maple bleeds red into green. Comes the time when the autumn colors roar. Comes the day when the timber dam breaks away.
place you see in paintings, but never dare to go. The winter snow, the leaves of fall, the summer birds that sing. But most of all, Algonquin is the black flies in the spring. Well, Greece has got them statues, and London's got Big Ben, and Paris got the nightclubs if the villa gets the yen. And somewhere called Arabia has magic flying rugs, but here we got billion of blood-sucking bugs. It's the Algonquin breakdown. When something I can hardly see drives me near right of my tree. The Algonquin breakdown. Damned if a bug ain't made a monkey out of me. Nets and duck boat by the ton, but come up here in May and hey, you're near as good as done. For let the winter snow begin to melt a bit, and then the billion bugs wake up and say it's chow time again. It's the Algonquin breakdown. When the abuse to the RTs, but the beauty hides a beast. The Algonquin breakdown. When every normal lad is driven mad by bugs and bogs and lice. Welcome to paradise!
Oh. 1917. The flies are as bad this spring as most of us can ever remember. There are a lot of theories about what happened to Tom that year. Suicide, murder, run off to parts unknown. But I guess being driven crazy by flies is as good as any of them.
You're certain you can find him?
I'm the guide, ain't I?
Have you known Tom long?
Ever since he started coming up here, 5 years now. Never seen you here before, though.
No, this is my first trip. It's beautiful.
Just like the Paytons, I guess. Expecting you, is he? You his mother?
I'm a colleague from Toronto. Are we almost there?
This is it?
This is where he lives.
Has been. Got a few favorite spots, but been here mostly this year.
Will he be back soon, do you think?
A few minutes, maybe. Or a few weeks.
A few weeks?
Never know with Thompson. A few needles short of a pine, if you know what I mean. Damn. God damn. Why can't I get that mother beloved Jesus Gray? Thompson. Artistic distemperament, they call it. Been getting away that lot this spring, but ain't what most folks think. Can spit more than he can bite, has Thompson. You probably ain't noticed, since you just met me, but Tom tries to be a lot like me. And he has a lot to live up to. Ever since he started coming down here, has a guy's license, like I do, $1 a year. And even did some fire ranging one summer. And he just sort of began to fit in as the years went on. And this place just drove him loco as the rest of us did.
Damn, that great.
I think it's rather good. A surprise.
Francis, how the hell did you get here?
A train.
then a very peculiar gentleman who insisted he was a guide.
Francis McGilvery in Algonquin Park. When was the last time you were north of Bloor Street?
The last time I was in that shack of yours in the city.
I remember.
Last month. It's good to see you. Of course, I thought I was going to be seeing you last month.
I had to get out of the city.
Earlier every year. It wasn't a completely wasted trip to your shack. Harris showed me those large canvases you're working on. The West Wind, the Jack Pine. I see you took my advice on that one, Sky.
Yes.
Those are the ones you're placing in the USA?
I'm not showing this year.
Why not?
They're not good enough.
They're beautiful. They'd sell in a second.
Have McCallum sell them. I could use the money.
They deserve to be hung first. To be seen.
I'm not hanging them.
Well, isn't this going nicely so far? So this is where you run to every spring. And the flowers are beautiful. And the wildflowers?
Everywhere but here.
I'm trying to change the subject.
Sorry.
Damn it, Tom, I'm 50 years old and I don't have the patience to beat around the bush. I like you and I like what you're trying to do. And you could use a woman like me. You're a good painter, Tom. It could help make you a better one.
It's art lessons you want to give me.
Those too, if you want them. Frankly, the men I meet in Toronto these days, you can suck blood out of with a straw. Some even call themselves artists. You throw a glass of beer in their face and they apologize to you for it. I'm sick to death of it. But you, Tom Thompson, you have passion. And if you spend most of it on your painting, so much the better. But just this once, I'll have a chance to mix my passion with some other primary color. And see just what the hell happens.
I can't tie myself down.
So who brought rope?
I can't sit around some clapboard house and invite your parents to dinner on Sunday night.
What? Or who are you talking about?
Time, Francis. Look. I started in April to paint the spring, stop, time on my boards. 60 of them, paint the park every day, April through June. The colors, the movement, the surprise. For weeks I couldn't do a damn thing, and now I can't keep up. I do 60 a week.
So do it. Time isn't the enemy, Tom.
It is. 35 years. I was, before I showed up at this park, and every year since, I seem to fall further behind. How do I catch up? How many bad paintings am I allowed before suddenly they start to see good enough?
I don't know. But while you're waiting for your passion and your paint to thin out and disappear in the flood, you might as well rage against it. I've always liked a little rage.
No more work today. We'll go for a walk, pick some wildflowers.
Just what I need in these shoes. Walk in the afternoon rain.
Storm front. Look at that gray. Need a guide back to the mowing?
Darling?
And did you notice Tom arrive yet?
No, that I did not. You've ever guessed it, Winnie. The place run by the likes of Shannon Fraser would ever end up an art gallery.
For one night, anyway. And Shannon's been meaning to tell Tom how nice it was of him to offer. A free Tom Thompson painting for every Willett Lodge guest. If that doesn't get them booking for next year, I don't know what will. I'll check inside. Money she mustn't worry, Shannon.
wondering, Winnie? It's my experience that Thompson always shows up eventually at the Mowat Lodge. You're the ladies from the war? To Finney Ridge.
The news for a change.
Fletcher won't like it, of course. The first time they let Canadians fight together, and look what happens. I was in France, you know, before I came here. You should see the hotels in France. Chandeliers, marble, starched cuffs. I always thought someday I'd own this really classy place. People, important people, would make a point to stay at Shannon Fraser's. I was even on my way up the ladder once, but, well, I developed a reputation.
You and Annie do a wonderful job here.
Yeah, well, my Annie. How does Thompson do that, Winnie? Change things. People. Hell, I'm a rough guy, I won't deny it. Truth be told, never tried too hard to do anything else. My Annie.
Anything yet?
No.
Still, it's going very well. You won't forget to thank Tom, will you, Shannon?
If he ever gets here, darling, I'll be here to thank him for all he's done for me.
He's been doing so well all winter. Hasn't had a drink since Christmas. I think he's trying really hard, but I don't know. He sees Tom and how people react to his paintings. Now he sees me painting. I've seen him looking at a few of my paintings when he didn't know I was watching him. It's like he sees something in himself somehow. At least, that's how I feel when I look at Tom's paintings. I think I like the skies from them the best. The evening skies. I should go.
I'll come with you.
Winnie, I know you don't see me as much as a suitor, and I need to say this. I know I'm not at all like Thompson. Have a good job and a solid future,
Martin,
and I love you. I'd be a good husband and father.
Can't marry you, Martin.
I know you may think you have some obligations, but there are some things you may not know. I was in Toronto this winter.
And
certain information came to my attention about the relationships with Thompson and certain people.
What people?
I'm looking for Tom.
Join the vigil, Miss McGilvery.
Miss Trainer. And you are?
Martin Bletcher.
Why do you look familiar, Mr. Bletcher? Have we met in Toronto?
I'm from Buffalo.
I've obviously interrupted something.
No. Excuse me.
I chose my allotted painting. Spring Ice, it reads.
I was there when he did that one. You can see that same island from here.
Different perspective.
Yes.
What is this place?
It's what passes as the Canoe Lake Cemetery.
Charming place to be lured. Who is James Watson?
He was a mill hand. Came here from Perry Sound and died his very first day on the job. Everyone around here knows his inscription by heart. Remember, comrades, when passing by, as you are now, so once was I. So I am now, so you will be. Prepare thyself to follow me.
I used to illustrate verses like that for a living.
This one's a little boy who died of diphtheria. He was 8.
Both of them too young. The ice is starting to move in the water. Colors, everything changing all the time.
No more painting today.
No.
Today's just for us. Hold me. The beginning, isn't it?
Yes.
I talked to Andy about the art truck mode idea, and it's all set. It's very nice of you to help them out in giving away your paintings.
It's either give them away or throw.
stop looking at me like that.
Letcher! Got everything you need? Something to drink? Stop by Dixon's on the way. What you got?
Nothing. Promised Annie I wouldn't. Don't need it. Take or leave a good drink. Water's fine. Tea. Sarsaparilla, that's the ticket.
See the painting he did of you?
Me.
Sugar Bush. You asked me, you pretty much painted you the color of dry blood.
Any there of Annie?
None that I saw. But some may not be for us to see.
I hear Todd Thompson and Winnie plan to be married.
I went out to where they camp.
In the dam.
Put on scene with Miss McGovery and one of the wives of his own painter friends.
Investigator investigates.
Told him I've been watching them all winter. In my line of work, I see men like you all the time. Poor, boring businessmen pay me good, planning to find where their poor, boring wives go. Well, they go to see men like you.
Leave it alone, Letcher.
You're not the only one who wants things. So does everyone else in this park. But what comes so easily to you does not come so easily to us. You take what she gives you, you don't appreciate it. Just like you dismiss your own paintings. A man should be proud of what he does and who he loves.
Winnie doesn't love you, Letcher.
She would, if it weren't for you.
Nothing comes easily, Letcher. You want something, you hack through the brush and go get it.
I want you out of this park. I want you out of this park, Thompson!
Shannon, people are starting to leave. I need you to come be the perfect host.
You still haven't shown us which piece you chose, Miss Shannon.
I see this and I see what's possible. I see what Tom can do with the right subject.
Surely that's not one of Tom's.
No, that's one of mine.
Thought I need a drink.
I must do my own work and live my own way because I am responsible for both.
Rudyard Kipling.
Yes. The Light That Failed. A wonderful name, Rudyard. Who do you know these days would name their son Rudyard?
You still could, Doctor?
I'd be afraid of having a son, lest he turn out like you and end up calling me Doctor my whole life. Did you read the book, or just design the beautifully engraved plate of a noble quote?
I read the book.
And you know what happened. Painter creates exquisite painting. Painter goes blind. Painter becomes obsessed. Painter's painting destroyed. Painter goes mad. Dies a horrible, tragic death. True, it's a 19th century novel, but there is a moral here, Tom. Do your work. Get paid for your work. Go home to your wife and children, one of whom should be named Rudyard.
I was working this morning. I'd done 3 or 4 boards, and I wanted to move on, so I left what I'd finished on the trail to dry. And I went up to the point, and I did a few more. I come back down the trail to pick up the first ones, and I did hear something scratching. So I go to where I left my boards, and what do I see? A lynx, gray, the kind of gray I can never goddamn get. And this lynx is scratching the hell out of my boards, paint all over its paws, but it keeps scratching. And suddenly it stops and looks at me. Just sort of looks at me, then looks at these boards it's been clawing. It felt like about a month we stood there. Finally sort of sneezes and disappears into the trees. Of course, the boards are ruined. Now I think this lynx has lived here its whole life. It knows these trees a hell of a lot better than I ever will. Like a true critic, it told me in no uncertain terms just what the hell it thought of my paintings. In fact, that goddamn gray lynx is telling me what I've been telling myself for years.
Well, perhaps my friend thought it was a tree.
You missed my art show at the mullet.
As I understand it, so did you. Besides, an art show where paintings are given away is far too painful a place for an agent. But it's not your paintings I'm concerned about at the moment, Tom. It's you.
What's the difference?
He missed you.
At any
Annie's, yes, I meant to be there.
It's not important. Did you write them at Bella Lake yet?
No, not yet.
Do you want me to do it?
Do what?
Write them at Bella Lake.
No, I'll do it.
Late summer's the busy time. We need reservations.
I know. I'll do it.
I need you to write them at Bella Lake.
I'm taking today's train back, Tom. My offer, if you remember it, still stands. What's this?
I've been painting plates for Winnie. Dinner plates, ashtrays, vases. It's a nice change painting something people might actually have a use for.
You're too good not to show in the OSA, Tom.
Put flowers in it. Hang it in the OSA. Thanks for your help with that sky.
Annie showed me the vase you painted for Frances, and she doesn't understand how it could have been left behind.
My Annie?
She's going to send it down to her in the city as soon as she can, she
said. It was just a vase.
She showed me how pretty it looks in the light.
How does he do that, Winnie?
I thought vase painting was the one thing I could probably keep under control.
Change things. People, I'm not afraid of you.
Nothing's under control.
Are you and Winnie getting married? Is it true you booked a honeymoon at Bella Lake?
I thought you wanted to make these plans.
I do.
I bested your strong hand.
I wonder how I shall really feel about this part, Tom.
Time isn't the enemy.
Answer me.
Just rage against it.
Hold me.
It proves to have cured me, but destroyed you.
A man should be proud of what he does and who he loves.
Tyler.
Tom, I'm sorry.
Annie.
It was an accident, I swear.
No, you did it on purpose.
Look at me.
God, I need a drink.
No, I swear, it just slipped through my fingers.
Painter goes mad.
It was just a vase.
I want you out of this park.
Please don't ever stop looking at me like that.
You're too damn good not to show me OSA, Tom.
Tommy Thompson!
Tom!
The colors in the storm burn like the sun. The colors in the storm roar like thunder. Sparks of light among the dark. Vulture and lark together form the colors in the storm. The fevers in the wind rumble and purr. The blood red and the gray rage like hurricane. In the silence and the din, outside and in, colors in the storm. High and the colors in the sky are churning, changing, energized, paralyzed, colorblind.
The colors in the storm sing like a swan. You catch them in the paint, then they're gone again.
Through the stillness and the blight, the darkness and light, fly, the colors in the storm, and I.
Sunday, July 8th. Tom starts off with his fishing equipment and a lunch packed for him by Shannon Fraser.
He told me he was going over to Gill Lake to catch as big as a trout he could and tell Mark Robinson it was the Baron. But I was at Gill Lake all day setting on a rock. And I didn't see Tom there the whole day.
We none of us ever saw Tom alive again. Monday the 9th, Martin Bletcher.
I'd like to ask him a few questions, I would.
Reports having seen Thompson's canoe overturned in the water the day before.
And did nothing about it. Towed the canoe to his own boathouse and waited a whole day to report it.
Upon examination of the canoe, none of Tom's equipment is found.
Except the portaging paddle. Which wasn't even knotted down proper. Tom would have never knotted it down like that.
When no word is heard from Tom by Wednesday, an official search is finally begun.
And what about the working paddle? Never found. Paddles float, you know. Paddles don't just sink to the bottom of a lake like a shotgun would.
The search continues through the following Sunday, but there's no trace. Then, Monday the 16th, a Dr. George Howland, vacationing on an island in Canoe Lake, notices something in the water offshore. Calls to a passing canoeist.
That was me.
To investigate.
And it was then we found Tom's body.
I get a picture yet? Not so good, is it?
I don't know anything about you.
Is that why you should come?
Where then? To see what?
Through the shadows, through the pine. Into the heart. It's up to you.
No, wait! I'll come!
Late morning, Tuesday, July 17th. When it is clear who it is has been found, Dr. Howland examines the body immediately. There is fishing line wrapped 16 or 17 times around one ankle. Some evidence from bleeding from one ear, no water in the lungs, and a 4-inch bruise across the left temple.
As if struck by the edge of a paddle.
It was a bruise. Could have happened 100 ways.
Sure. And a paddle and canoe just disappear without trace.
When the coroner is delayed, the park superintendent authorizes Tom's body to be buried in the small Canoe Lake Cemetery. Martin Bletcher Sr. reads the service. Winnie Trainer leaves the same night for Huntsville.
I used to know when I made you angry. I always loved you. You never let me get away with anything.
I'm not angry.
You want to make plans. I haven't been very helpful. When I first saw you, the wind had caught your hair and it looked so wild.
The wind does with my hair is not
me. It is. I've been thinking of going to the Rockies. Here in the park, maybe I've been painting the same thing for too long. But it's like I can't turn the next bend, take the next step. I haven't painted for weeks. I thought maybe somewhere else.
No one's stopping you. Are you going to the Rockies or running away from here?
I want to be wherever I have to be.
You don't have to be anywhere else. What you've done here...
What I've done isn't the point. What I'm capable of is the point. Winnie, it's like when the light hits the water, just so, and you see this amazing color. It's there, and then it's gone, a fraction of a second. You get it down on the board, and there it is. Then someone says it's not right. No, you couldn't possibly have seen that color. You knew it existed, but you can't prove it to anybody else. And suddenly you begin to doubt. Maybe what you saw wasn't actually there. Maybe you still haven't gotten it right. Suddenly you have to go on faith, and faith is so hard.
Faith in what? That you're going to be a great painter?
Great painter. I'm no different than you or Dixon or Annie.
But I'm not like you. I have to know what to expect. Now, tonight.
Come with me.
What?
Now, tonight, to the Rockies, to France. To hell with our plans. Things change too fast. You have to catch them, color them before they change. We can do that. Winnie, you can do that. Yes, it's a risk. Sure, it takes courage, but you only get so many chances, and I nearly missed mine. 35 years old, and what was I? The man I was before I got here, you wouldn't have wanted.
Stop it.
I wouldn't let you settle for the man I was before I found all this. Before I finally faced what it is in me that needs to do this. Face that in yourself, Winnie.
I said stop it! You think you're the only one with courage? The only one that's willing to take risks? What are you in my life if not a risk? One that up until this very moment I've been willing to take. Who's the one with courage, Tom, and who's the one running away? I think you're fake. I think that for all your passion and your genius, if that's what it is,
they look like you paint them to look. But I love you. Please come inside.
We'll go tonight. I need you, Winnie. But I need you with the wind in your hair. Who's that? Thompson, that you? You here for Hooch?
I'm here to get out of the rain. You told me once if it was raining I should come to your shack.
It ain't raining.
I found that pine.
So?
You know Wild Mary? You know where I can find her?
Yeah.
I have to talk to her.
Now that's gonna be harder.
I have to.
She's dead, Thompson. She's been dead 15 years.
No, I've seen her.
Buried her myself. Come out here for something.
No, she was real.
She looks real, and the moon's just right. I saw her once, standing right on the spot where I buried her. When I went to go grab her, she was gone.
Dixon!
You better go too. Fraser's inside, and Bletcher. Fraser's saying tonight best you stay away. Go to the lodge, or Winnie's. How'd you manage to get so many people mad at you at the same time?
I love her, you know. I do. Hey, what's that?
Tingling.
These are old boards of mine. Where'd you get all these?
I didn't steal nothing. Some you gave to me, and some I found on the ground when you threw them.
You should look at them. Is it any wonder I tossed them?
Ever since that one of my shacks sold for $400, I've been collecting them for my old age.
Dixon, what's keeping that hooch?
Let's go. Gotta find Wild Mary.
Dixon.
Well, if it ain't the great Tom Thompson. Come by for an arm wrestle, have ya? Or is it painting lessons tonight? Is my Annie here too, then? Learn to paint the moon? I miss her. You know that, Thompson? My Annie. The Annie who used to think I was something, who needed Shannon Fraser to make her feel like something. Changed me too, Thompson. They're giving me painting lessons.
What's he doing here? No women here. You know, we've been talking about you, Thompson. I've been a little worried that Shannon hasn't been himself lately. He's a bit more himself tonight. I'm telling about the things you've been doing up in the city. Probably up to the same things you're doing up here in the park. Are you listening to me? The kind of man you are, Thompson, does not deserve a woman like Winnie. And I'm not going to stand by here any longer and keep watching you destroy things.
Forget it, Martin. Ain't worth the effort.
Like it ain't worth the effort to keep the man away from your own wife.
I can take care of my own wife. Do I look like I ain't noticed how he's been making my Annie think she deserves better than Shannon Fraser?
So, what are you going to do about it?
Do what I have to. It's any business of yours, Fletcher.
Is that what you think, Thompson? The Annie deserves a damn better sight than Shannon Fraser.
What I think, Fletcher, is that Winnie deserves a hell of a lot better than you.
Seems he's a better man than both of us.
Well, then maybe it's time he finally proved it. You want my wife, Thompson? Challenge me to a duel. Drown me in my sleep, and the two of you can go off together and paint the moon.
I don't want to fight you, Shannon.
Well, ain't that just the picture of a man? Backing away from a challenge. Too much of an artist to fight? Well, it takes guts. Fight for something with your good hand. So you got no excuses if you lose.
Mike, it's just a cut. Get a rag.
Randy!
Don't just stand there! Shannon! Shannon, get back here!
Late on the morning of late in the evening of Tuesday, July 17th, the coroner finally arrives in the park and an inquest is held in the home of Martin Bletcher.
Of all places.
The coroner takes evidence, mostly from Dr. Howland, and concludes death by drowning. No one else has much to say.
I had plenty to say, only I weren't invited.
Next night, an undertaker arrives in Huntsville to exhume Tom's body and return it to the family cemetery near Owen Sound. This happens without my knowledge. And Shannon Fraser, who helped the undertaker carry the coffin to the train, says that the coffin that was shipped to Owen Sound was not heavy enough to contain a body.
Don't none of it make no sense.
The family insists that his body's in the casket when it is buried in the family churchyard.
But Shannon Fraser swears...
And they make it clear that they want nothing to do with solving any mystery about the whereabouts of Tom's body. Officially, it is death by drowning, and Tom's body is reinterred in Leith, Ontario.
He was our friend. Should have none of it ever happened.
I don't know why I could never speak up that night. Maybe it was where the inquest was held. Maybe it was who was there. But I've said it before, and I'll state right here that I don't think Tom Thompson died an accidental death from drowning that afternoon of July 9th. And God forgive me if I'm wrong, but I still believe Tom's body is buried right here.
They moved the body.
Kids from the summer camp come to leave flowers. I guess they think it's respectful.
Can you keep it well tended? It must have been hard for you. I understand you were to be married.
Tom tell you that?
No.
Then we're discussing a rumor, aren't we? I don't discuss rumors. You're from the city, one of Tom's artist friends.
Yes.
So many people loved his art.
He's an artist.
or sky, what colors would I use? No grays. Yellows, blues. And today, reds.
Miss Trainer? I'm sorry, I shouldn't have intruded. I'm not usually sentimental about this kind of thing. But it's eerie. Everywhere you look here, you see one of his paintings. Look up there. It says it.
No more work today. We'll go for a walk. Pick some wildflowers.
I'll let you have a few minutes alone.
No, please. I feel him too.
Did he talk to you about painting? Is that why you loved him? Because of what he said, how he felt about them?
No.
Look at the light on the water. It looks like one color, but it's dozens of colors. Can you see them?
It was never what he said about things that mattered. It was what he saw.
I tried to see that. It's so hard.
The color of everything changes all the time, you know.
Until Tom came back from the park for the first time, I'd forgotten how someone can look at you. As if they're looking into the very part of you tried so hard to keep hidden. It was wonderful and awful.
It's frightening.
Fly with me to the Rockies when you train.
So many people are going to be moved by what he did. Are going to love him for what he saw in these trees, and this water, and that sky. Why did you love him?
Because of what he saw in me.
It's like shooting rapids. You're never sure if it's you in control or the river. I dumped once in white water, and there we were, ass over tea kettle, plummeting down this river. Me, the canoe, my kit, and all the boards I'd done over that last week. It was a near thing, but I made it. Eventually, I bailed the canoe, my clothes dried, and the campfire burnt the water off the bacon, but those boards. I'd done one the same day of that river, tried to get the power and the paint, the color of the underpool, the roar. When I'd finished with that board, it sang, it threatened, and it didn't last a day. It's funny, people say water and oil don't mix. Well, here, what had once been water and oil was now more water than oil, and all the colors running together like rivers themselves, and the whole damn mess, no use to anybody. And it kind of made me think of those old fields that get reclaimed after the years by the forests they'd once been cleared from. Ashes to ashes, dust to dust, and water and oil to water. But I'm damned if I didn't scrape that board down and start in on it again the next day. And the first picture I did was of that white water.